Come on, bitch, I said it's all about the. Come on, it's all about the. Y'all said it's all about the. Come on, it's all about the.
I apologize for snatching your wig accidentally, on purpose, intentionally, maliciously, blindsided, drunkenly, whatever. I don't want to have this issue. I don't need that shit.
And I accept your apology. The way that you thought or expected Zulu to be there for you in that moment, Gio actually was there in that moment for me, because in that moment I felt offended. And that's my friend.
I think they're just fake for the show.
Royal.
Ooh.
That's what she's saying.
I agree.
You think Royal fake?
He's fake for the, when the camera comes on, he's a whole different person.
That mama oil his little bird chest up there, boy.
Nobody from my team was coming but me and Gio. So we could have been just one team the whole time.
Action. What happened here?
You my outfit, babe.
Oh.
That we need to handle.
You didn't choke me. Same girl that sat there and was like, oh, you look like a fucking fool. Go into a performance with the same clothes you had on yesterday. Cool. The same bitch that was clowning you.
You cannot take them anywhere without arguing.
We're not here for Zulu. We're here
the fuck?
Because so Gio tried you and you look like Derek.
You said, I am. We looking ghetto.
We are ghetto.
At this point, it's too late.
Keep stumbling. Keep fumbling. Hey, my circle stays small as hell. My homies, I know them well. For me to warm up, it's gonna take a while. Can't force some things, gotta play it out. Shit get real, gotta watch your back. Need a team to watch your back. Keep your balance, make sure you're aight. See, the squares can't fit when your circle's tight.
I got a small circle. No room for your squares. Keep a small circle. See you below, way over there. What you doing, homie? Who you know from over here? I got a small circle. No room for no squares, keep a small circle. No room for no squares, got a small circle. See you below, way over there. What you doing, homie? Who you know from over here? I got a small circle. No room for no squares, keep a small circle. No room for no squares, got a small circle. See you below, way over there. What you doing, homie? Who you know from round here? I keep a small circle.
Yeah. It's been a cow. Hey, you definitely did tell us that you said it.
Yeah, you did.
Because I felt like you came to my house and you disrespected my home.
Okay.
You disrespected my home.
You should have said that right then and there.
But I kicked him out of my house.
Wait.
Y'all keep trying to get that from me because of what I'm going through.
Okay, but at the end of the day, what you're going through does not justify the fact that you went somewhere.
You called the
cops.
So
I'm encouraging Royal to defend himself.
Yeah, bitch, I should have smacked you right then and there.
I'm not touching nobody. I'm letting it go because I'm done with that. I'm above that.
You came, but you're not above that.
This is my sister. Nobody is really about it.
Her time is coming because my patience is wearing thin.
Did y'all go check and see Gio's okay?
I don't know that either one of them are in any position to be fighting for top But I don't understand their beef. It doesn't make any sense to me.
Bitch, you said you wanted to hit you.
All right, so nobody's popping on nobody with the next
box. It's
over. You never get into the bottom of it.
I'm not a mind reader, I'm not a fortune teller, but I would say bet your money on Gio Glam. How about that?
I thought that Gio was bullying you.
Right.
And then what happened?
He admitted to what he said.
He said he was gonna do it.
I'm not in the spirit of fighting somebody that don't wanna fight me. But bitch, I'm gonna keep pressing the issue in your face because you're not gonna punk me either.
I'm not hitting him because you're gonna call the cops.
So Natalie is a cop caller.
The fuck?
I'm Natalie.
I'm definitely Megan.
But I do believe that he will call the police.
Sorry, y'all embarrassing me. Y'all get out.
You got Cakey over here thinking that she's gonna egg it on, which, yeah, she's my friend in this moment, but it's like, I kind of feel like she really wanted to see a fight. What I look like fighting somebody that's scared of me.
Hey, Mustafa!
What trouble you was?
Mustafa!
You was fired. Oh, okay. Gloria. Gloria. Mustafa. Do some more, Mustafa. Do some more. And that's what you wanted? You wanted Mustafa?
You gonna call the cops, and I don't have time for it. If you was a real nigga about that life, we could have duffed it out. You know what I'm saying? It would have been that, because that's what I'm used to.
You know, this is the family, y'all. This is my son, Quincy.
Hey, Quincy. Nice to meet you.
This is Day Day.
Hi, Day Day.
It's my image consultant.
Okay.
Period. This is my dad, Chocolate. I'm getting ready to start a house. Well, an NYC chapter of the house. And he's in it. Roy was in it.
Okay.
What you doing in there?
Who was in it?
What you, the housekeeper?
Not the housekeeper.
So, what are you going to work in the house?
You said what?
What are you going to work in the house?
I'm going to do what I need to do.
Okay. You're going to do your big one?
Period.
Got it.
Category?
Several.
That's
you
right.
The huh? You walked the ball before?
Yeah.
Shout out to us finishing two projects.
The cast did an amazing job. Because I did not know that I could get in touch with being a character.
I played a trans man.
It was so emotional to me. And I really, I enjoyed doing it. I really did.
We are in a cast full of artists. I'm going to leave it at that. I'm not going to talk about anybody's artistry because everybody's artistry is different.
Being an artist in the music industry, you have to tap into that too. So I thought this was great to have me, because I did do it years ago. I had to kiss a man and it made me upset.
Kenzie was telling me, hey, you know, I heard this, I seen this, you know, congratulations. I'm on every chart except for Billboard, bitch, but I'm going to get there.
You are, yes.
I'm on the weekly top 40 chart. I don't know about any of y'all, but.
Like, I just want to know, may I answer? I feel like anybody can be on an iTunes chart. Like, you know, there's a formula.
I'm on the charts. I don't know about anybody else. I don't know how charts came up, but.
I don't compare myself to any artist on this cast.
Kenzie said the only person on the charts is me.
That conversation was misunderstood.
I don't think that conversation was misunderstood at all. I think that conversation was misplaced. I'm an artist, you're referring to me. I'm not on the charts, but bitch, my music will sit over any artist at this table, and bitch, I can rap right now to prove that.
I just mind my business.
Yeah, I gotta get my niggas together, cause this is crazy.
I'm getting literally 4 to 5 different stories.
It was really disappointing, man. I was kind of pissed off. I came here to vibe for my niggas, and instead I'm looking like a clown right now, a little bit, like a lost bitch.
But I didn't.
I just said, like, it felt like you were discrediting.
I didn't say
that. You were discrediting.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna say this.
That's how
I don't need nobody to
speak
for me. I don't need nobody to speak for me.
Kenzie said it.
No,
that's not my friend.
Hold on, wait.
You didn't say it. You should have let her bring us to the group.
It doesn't matter.
You wanted the girls to know.
Stick to you. I don't need you to fight nobody. Not everybody's a fighter. Not everybody's none of that.
I wasn't trying to offend anybody.
I was given my roses in the moment, and it was about me and other people using that moment to feel attacked.
Keep your energy in your energy. Keep it in your ball court.
Kenzie, did you feel the need to bring it back to the group, or was that just a comment?
It was stated that I made the statement, but
so
I
who
didn't
made
ever
the statement?
Make
it. Bitch, we talking about these imaginary charts that all the girls want to motherfucking be on. Bitch, ain't nobody on no real chart.
Fuck these hoes. Don't let them drag you out of your fucking energy.
I
I just feel like Gio Royal. Like, I just
if he's the one who really said that, bitch, I'm gonna be mad.
And like, I'm trying to give that girl the benefit of the doubt. We done made up.
She's really fucking annoying. She's really annoying. She loves to bark, and it's just barking for no reason. Like, every fucking argument, every time I've seen this girl, she was arguing with somebody. It's old and it's tired and it's fucking annoying. Like, the fact that she was the one who made that comment about nobody on the chart, like, bitch, are you kidding me? Could you even write one fucking line of music? Could you write it?
She's a ballroom girl.
And you can't even tell me what category you are.
Several.
I'm over it. Several, damn. Bitch. I said, what did you walk at the bar? Several.
I said, at least pick one.
Okay,
she
just
probably,
one.
She's so probably get annoying. She's a liar.
And she doesn't stand on what she says. Like, every time you be like, oh, she's did you hater. Say this, girl, she pulls back.
I don't know who's her friends. Like, I don't know who she's cool with in this circle. I don't know. Who she
I don't
want to like
know.
Like, you see,
I don't
like,
want to know.
I'm an outsider and it's fine.
Yeah, I don't want to know and I don't want to be cool with her. Like, I
she
can't be cool
even,
with her.
But no, like, she disrespected your house. Y'all, yeah. You and Gio,
I know.
And then you I turn that around and get mad at them.
It was not an accident.
She was getting mad at people
a
because.
Snatch is not an accident.
It's not. You don't snatch a bitch wig off on accident.
The doll snatched her up. She was embarrassed, as she should be.
I don't think it's valid.
It's embarrassing.
Well, she was just embarrassed. And one thing about her is she cannot handle her emotions. She is not emotionally mature.
And that's. Really
she's just not emotionally mature. She can't handle her emotions. Every time I see her, she's either screaming, she's crying, she's getting choked the fuck up. Like, it's just always something with her. I can't.
So she's the one that plants the seeds and nothing grows but toxin. It just
weed.
Peaches is entitled to her own opinion. If she was offended, then you know that was Peaches' decision. Cause you know everybody's an artist nowadays.
Hey.
What's going on? Just chit-chatting.
What y'all chit-chatting about?
Just
everything.
Like, so what's that was fake a whole, nothing. Like,
everything.
That's what I'm saying, like,
you bitches are still on the level I am, so I'm not gonna allow another bitch to come in my space and try to demean my career. Sorry.
I can see how he took it offensive the way that girl brought it up.
Because we never had a conversation.
Live for your music.
Right,
it's not even about that.
You show me love.
It's not. I showed you love. It's not even about that. It's really about the tone. I just didn't like the way you said it. Oh, I'm the only bitch on the charts. What does that mean?
I never said that.
I'm on the charts. I don't know about anybody else.
So what was the point of you bringing that to the table? I just don't understand. Okay, and I didn't like that.
I never said that she wasn't on the chart. I never said that.
I mean, I get my streams and I have my motherfucking credentials. But I don't gotta brag. I let
me
my
either.
Performances, I let my music
and
my work speak for
it.
You
love,
just said that,
performing?
And I still just didn't like the way you
right,
said that.
Saying,
that rubbed me the wrong way. I felt the need to defend my career and defend my artistry because I feel another bitch is trying to demean that.
Y'all are dragging it. Y'all gotta be bothered. Like, I don't feel like it should have bothered y'all that much.
So I mean, we could disagree.
We could disagree to disagree because I wasn't referring to you.
Okay.
And bitch, we all could be on the chart.
And I'm with
point.
That. Like,
and that's where I'm at. We,
it's no love
have,
lost.
We all on the same page. We all trying to do the same
thing.
We
all trying to get to it.
Yeah. I haven't seen you on no charts. I haven't seen you make no big major moves. So, bitch, until you do that, then you can holler at a bitch like P. Until then, girl. It's curtains.
I know you invite some of these girls to your studio sessions and you give them some bars and they rehearse them and they record them.
I don't write for nobody.
Don't bring them to mind.
Well, but you should. Maybe you should.
Please don't bring them to mind.
I don't write for anybody. I write
she
my own.
Just keep them far away from me.
The studio session is not a playground. It's a playground for people
like, no.
to really play. But
that.
You can't play with them.
Who push a pin.
It's like the ballroom. She really ain't going to be in your house.
Don't do none of that. I'm always on your side. But let me have your back on and...
Okay.
Crazy.
I did a few years ago a Pride PJ jammy.
Uh-huh.
But you had to come in a sexy like lingerie type of vibe.
That sounds fun.
I don't know if I would invite all the girls though.
So,
cause I want to do something with, like my little sis Zulu can come, but I want to do something with the older girls that can come.
But she's not.
Champagne.
But see, that's a contradiction.
Sure, everyone except Gio Royal, and it's only because I do feel like we had a conversation, and I wanted to let bygones be bygones. Like he got a lot of stuff going on that I give my heart to. You know what I'm saying? But I need you to be the same person. Keke, can I get a real moment, real quick?
Yeah, baby.
Because I respect something. The other day that she was asked. Who she feels is the fakest, and she already made it clear to the one person that she felt was, but then she brought up somebody else that I was literally sitting there thinking, I'm like, I'm not gonna say it, cause I don't wanna, you know, I'm trying to be nice to her, but it was real because it's, who are you? On, like, on the scene, off the scene, like it's a different person.
Move, because you were. Move, you always doing that gay shit.
I just, and I feel bad even
right,
now.
Right, bitch, you not even going to say bye to the girl?
That's why I'm about to get a new man.
She out.
So you, that's what I mean by the ancient girl. Pajama jam, something sexy for the older girls. But I would invite Zulu because I think Zulu can hang. But I don't know if I want to invite Gia.
Well, maybe I think that would be a. I think that would be a.
Yeah,
I do think
so.
I do think that would
break the ice, child.
She keeps freezing it back up. She keeps putting it back in the freezer.
Like I don't like refreeze ice.
I know who you are, for real, for real. Stop letting them drag you to be the other person. Stop.
Oh, you really want me to?
Can Ruffy get it?
Oh! Can he get what? Some directions? Can he get what?
Can you get the cake?
You feel better?
Can he get the cakes? You're dumb to believe that he wouldn't fucking get the cakes, bitch. I will fuck that nigga 6 way to Sunday. Like, bitch, are you kidding me? That nigga's fine as fuck.
She want a moment so bad, and girl, if you're the moment, it will happen. But you're obviously not the moment.
So you're having a pajama party, but she's not invited, basically.
She ain't make the guest list in my head.
AKA,
right now.
So can we have plus one? Because she would be my plus one. I'm just saying. I like y'all, boo. But
I like you too. You about to change that.
We're all trying to make things happen, so it's definitely no competition amongst a lot of us. I mean, I can only speak for myself. So I think Peaches is a better artist than me. We don't even rap about the same shit.
So you're going to take responsibility
for that? I would take responsibility for that.
Yeah, if she get there yelling and doing all of that.
I'm not even going to look her out of eye.
I'm going to just look straight at you. And I'm going to say, get your friend.
From what I can tell, because every time we link up, it don't seem like he like to wear underwear. So, bitch, that dick be saying hey, and I'm saying hi, babe.
So I just got booked by them this Saturday.
I was conducting myself as a lady and an artist, and I was then offered to come back to perform for Pride.
They cut off all 5 blocks.
Where is it? Yeah.
It's
going to
be on this block.
Oh, I'm coming. I'm there.
This Saturday.
Okay.
What
time
is it gonna be? I get a notification in our little group chat from my D, and there's a subliminal message posted. And it says, the girls are struggling for storylines and studio time.
That wasn't referred to me, right? Correct? Because I did put out a video. So I just want to know that wasn't referred to me.
I really want to know who the fuck was this about. Like, who are you referring to?
Again, was it for me? I don't care if it was. I'm not about a if it was type of person. Was it for me?
There's no need to get rowdy.
I'm not getting rowdy. I'm just asking a question. And he's talking about some if it was. Right, but you didn't make the post.
I know it can't be referred to me. Since you like to throw stones and hide your hands, I'm about to check this.
And being very extra.
I don't really care about all that. Who was that about? Was that about me?
I'm literally at home.
Great.
So what?
It's giving it was about you.
It was about you, boo. Yeah. Right.
Definitely doing little things to aggravate people because you did not need to put that.
I'm just asking you, was it about me? All the extra
yes
stuff,
no.
All the extra stuff, I really, if it's not about me, I will calm down.
It was generalized.
So it was about Keke too. No, it's not about that. And I'm not into that. I'm not into all that. No. I'm not. I didn't struggle either.
You're not even in attendance right now. So you're sitting at home bored watching us or thinking about anything that we're doing for you to even put that up on social media.
It was about you.
There is never a time where
fifth time
will ever be able to call and check me about.
Sixth time.
Let this, I want you to take this with you. Let this be the last time that it happened.
Okay, it'll happen again because I don't play that. As a fire sign, you should know that. But you don't ever tell me what should be the last time because now I'm going to make it the next time. Hang up on her like Keke did.
He's definitely starting to rub me the wrong way. And I think it's because of this situation that happened with him and Royal. I'm my own individual and I definitely did not get involved in that.
This is the first and the last conversation that you and I will have about social media.
Okay, that's cute. But again, if I feel another type of way, you will be addressed.
Now he's like trying to attack me, but he's definitely attacking the wrong person.
You can't buck up at me. No bitch on this cash can buck up at me. But what I'm saying is, I would have respected had you said, this is not. There will be a next time. You did say what you said, and I asked you.
You're giving her too much time, girl.
Zulu and Royal always arguing. Gio Glam is a messy bitch who does a lot of shit behind the scenes. I don't know what happened between King and Derek.
I feel like Derek.
Nothing happened with me and the ancient.
The girls are trying to gang up, the ones who came back for season 6, because their career didn't pop off in season 5. So they're trying to do what they couldn't do last season. Look at my motherfucking husband.
Hi, Rossi.
Hola. This so many other stories and people throwing in their 2 cents on things and saying this happened or this. And it, the people that literally have the beef at a certain point don't even know what they're beefing about because it's so like all over the place. So older guys, they take things and think that everybody's doing it for storylines.
I agree with you, Rocky. The vibe I get is they don't want us here and they always make comments and I always listen like, oh, we're interns. I don't even know if y'all gonna stay here. Y'all don't even know if y'all gonna be here. You don't notice every time they get together, they're just quiet, like they literally don't wanna get to know. We gotta give Gio Glam a little bit credit because he do hang out with us. I will give him that. He hangs out with us, he talks to us. You know,
even I wouldn't say that's giving him credit. That's calculated. He has a part to play, and he's gonna do what he needs to do to make sure that he plays that part.
But he could, whatever part he's playing. At least he hung out with us, aside from them other bitches that has been on the show before that. But even though he does a lot of behind the scenes sneaky shit,
I do feel like he's a fake out coach, but I do feel like he has had very genuine moments. It's just hard to those genuine moments when you're being messy and those messiness corralled everything else. And that's why I like when the girls get drunk. It's because I always get vindicated. Because one thing a drunk tongue gonna do is tell the truth, period. And
I'm doing good. There's a lot of tension in the group, and I feel like the dynamic needs to shift. So I want to host a 25 and up playdate at the Dollhouse.
I know what you came for.
No drama. I just want us to get together, have a good time, talk, and enjoy the food.
I invited some of the guys and girls from the cast to, you know, just hang out and kind of have deeper conversations. I feel like I've seen everybody in passing, and every time we get together, there's always drama.
I've been cooking all day. Food brings people together. It makes you feel better, especially when you have comfort food, food that's heavy in your body, warms your soul.
Shrimp Alfredo toast, mushroom risotto, chicken ricotta.
Okay.
Green beans, roasted potato. Oh yeah, we're gonna eat real good.
We've got smothered chicken. Like the menu was menuing, okay?
And then I already started setting up outside with the charcuterie board.
Yeah, it is. So I hope they appreciate this meal because the doll dropped a coin on y'all today.
This looks like something.
It looks the fuck good, don't it? I know. When the doll does it, he does it. Y'all getting plastic because I'm not gonna be washing dishes all night. Can y'all help me move those wine glasses over here? Because I want the liquor and stuff close to us.
I would like to see the older members of the group be examples and take more leadership in how we steer this ship.
Bitch, I'm nervous.
Why are you nervous?
Cause I hope they like the food. Like,
you cook.
I know. Some of these people just, I feel like it's like unnecessary drama and shade, and I'm just, you know how I am. I just, it's not my vibe. So that's why I wanted my own thing.
I'm only gonna invite people into my home that I feel carry good energy, won't disrespect me, won't stir the pot, and won't risk me being evicted.
Hello. Hey, Gio.
How you doing? Dawn.
How are you?
When Derek decided that he wanted to have a 25 and up party,
I kind of chuckled because it was very apparent who he wanted in his space.
Whine a little, you'll feel better.
Yes, yes, yes.
Excited to see what's on the menu for dinner. I actually want to see who actually is coming too.
This is Brian. This is our LGBTQ liaison for the Newark Police Department. He's one of our friends. He's working with Newark Pride too.
This is the first time that the circle has really let youth take over their season. And not that it's a bad thing, but in this case, it's not a great thing, let's be honest.
Nobody taking care of me. Nobody. Nobody's fucking taking care of me, my fucking self.
Robbie called me and told me that Peaches was wrapped and that he was gonna come.
Oh, well then that's news to me.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So, well, if they get here, there'll be plenty of food if y'all don't eat it all.
Kenzie said he was coming.
Kenzie told me that he declined the invitation. He said he had rehearsal.
Oh, he does have that show. And it's, yeah. Like, it's Saturday.
So yeah.
Saturday.
He had rehearsal. I was like, I totally understand that. So it was, you know, there'll be plenty more opportunities to eat. May not be my food. This is invite only.
I think that everyone who is 25 and up should be here.
Everybody who was over 25 was not invited.
So cheers to being out and queer. Cheers to progress. Cheers to friendships. Cheers to being successful black gay men. Cheers, guys.
Yes.
Cheers. As far as us being a group and being a collective, I think that with us being of a certain age, there is a responsibility.
Dig into the food.
We want to build a group of professionals. We have to show them what these interactions need to look like.
We got room for one more thing. I forgot I had these.
Yeah, shrimp kebabs.
Shrimp kebabs. I saw it on the menu.
I, you know, don't know what to expect. Hi, how are you?
Brian.
I'm Kenzie.
Brian.
Good to meet you. Come on, John. What's going on? Something to drink, something to eat. And that, you know, we have a party, we have fun.
Y'all think I made too much food? This is just the appetizers. We have a whole dinner.
You got your coochie coming for the charcuterie.
Right. It's Hoochie Daddy.
All summer.
I definitely think that we have a lot of messy girls in this circle.
I would like this event to be a positive event because that is the reason why I'm hosting this event. At a certain age, we're kind of operating a little differently in how we move and what's important to us.
Tonight, I feel like that he just wants all positivity tonight. I feel like that he doesn't want to talk about the drama that's going on in the circle.
The people I invited tonight were Gio,
present.
Chandler, Kenzie, John, Ralphie, Chloe, Robbie, Peaches, Brandon, and I think, did I miss anybody? And aside from like my other friends, I think, yeah. So those are the people that were invited to attend tonight's gathering. And I'm also very aware that there is some other issues going on in the group, particularly dealing with either with me or with Gio from some of the other cast members.
The issue that I had with Royal specifically had to do with the fact that you came into my home as a guest and you put your hands on another guest. What I'm not gonna do is just full out come and just fight you because I can or because you have an audience, because the same vigor and energy that he gave at the comedy show was not the same vigor and energy that he gave when it was the two of us. And we're just gonna leave it at that. I'm not a kid, and you were disrespectful. All of the others wanted to chime in with, oh, you're a bully and you're a this, and I'm like, well, wait a second, specifically Mustafa. You're a bully, Gio, and I said, well, wait a second, you wasn't even there, what did I say? Well, I heard, see, that's why we call you the bone collector. Like, I walked away from that situation. What did he do? Chase me down the street, taking off clothes in the middle of the street. That's the wrong franchise.
But the issue is very petty. I will say that from the beginning, from their side, they feel like there's a narrative that you all align together.
And we do.
Which is fine, but I'm saying that as if they should, I guess they feel like they should bow to you all.
Every time we're all around each other, there are these digs, and then like now you're going and pulling my Instagram stories and making something out of nothing. I didn't disrespect anybody. I didn't come for anybody. I wasn't shady. I wasn't like, oh, you're trying to get my, I didn't
because I don't care.
I know my girl, Miss D, is not here. I don't know if it was strategic. She's an older girl as well.
But because of the pot stirring she did with the whole screenshotting my Instagram and gaslighting people in the group and having them kind of like attack me, I feel like you were setting it up so that these people would attack me or look at me in a different light.
Basically, they had posted a story and they were like how people are struggling with music videos and storylines and shit like that.
So Mama, from what I seen, Mama reposted Derek's story.
No, she didn't.
Oh, yeah.
She didn't repost
that on the group chat
for us to see it. Because nobody goes to Derek with his 230 followers page. Nobody's going traffic to his page. So nobody was going to see that.
It's not about us thinking that we're better. I am from a previous season, which means I've gone through this experience before. With you being a new person, there's an opportunity for me to help you through this experience. I know a lot of them are younger and they may not see it now, but this could literally set them up for the next level. If someone like Zulu, he's a little rough on edges, but Zulu gets it.
Yeah.
Like Zulu gets it. I don't think the penny has dropped in a lot of the others yet. It's very irritating when you set a boundary with somebody and they keep pushing it.
Yeah, is that why you didn't invite this dude?
Yes. Yeah. Well, that's one of the elders of the group. She did that from nowhere. So I can only imagine if she were here, what would it be? What would your message be to the rest of the group that's not here?
I think you should have a conversation with Miss D, because I don't think that if Miss D was here without the youths, that, you know, she would act in any inappropriate way.
It's my money. It's my food. I invited who I wanted to be here. This wasn't your time to be here. Maybe the next time. This just wasn't the event for you to be.
She's friends with my partner. But you're not invited into to this space.
Everything ain't for everybody, right? And that's okay.
I do not care why Madi was not invited. I think that there are a lot of piglets who like to play in mud and then pretend as if they are these beautiful swans. And that's fine if that's your narrative. But when you're a messy little piglet and you get caught, then it is what it is. You're a messy piglet. So just be a piglet. Or a hippo.
I felt like a bunny rabbit next to a fucking hippo.
I think there are a lot of people who are creating their own smaller circles. And every time you see a previous season, you get that new person that comes on. And what's the first thing they think they're about to do? Mm-hmm. Come in and be the I love New York Tiffany Pollard.
Oh, like you did.
But like the difference is that
I think that Kinsey is entitled to feel however he wants to feel. I know that he has a relationship, I guess, with Madi.
The kids are gonna do what they do, and like maybe we just need a 25 and over group, 30 and over group moment. We get it.
She can stay where she is, and if you didn't make the list, you just didn't make the list, boo.
For me, I am not in that divide. I feel like I'm like, you
know, in the middle.
I'm not in the middle because I'm not going to be in the middle. I'm going to step to the side and let what transpires transpire because I'm not getting in it.
Some of these people who I feel like are curating these narratives of like, let me have drama. What do you do with the rest of your day when you're not in front of this camera?
Kinsey, you did your big one for your friend. She still ain't invited.
Hello.
Well, we're still on our observe.
In this moment, I'm getting very irritated.
Everybody's had scenes, everybody's had things, and I ain't been there. I don't get invited to y'all house. I don't get invited to, you know what I'm saying? So nobody should feel any type of way about not being here.
If you're not bringing positivity and light into my space, you can't come in my space.
So I'm getting ready to move, so.
Are you?
Okay. Yeah, we're moving. We're not staying in that apartment anymore. It's been cursed.
It's been cursed? You let the people coming in and fuck it up before they left?
Weird, funky, faggot ass shit. Over here at 803
White Claw,
bitch.
Oh.
I don't give a fuck.
All right, food's ready. If y'all want to eat, I seasoned the food like a white lady that takes black dick. Let me go. I think I don't even want real liquor here at this event with these people.
Yeah. I'm gonna just get a little here. At some point in time, cheddar bay biscuits.
Not getting that.
Michigan.
Nope.
No?
I can't really do dairy, like cheese and shit.
Oh, what does it do to you?
It fucks my stomach up, and then I can't buy it.
Food is a love language. This is me expressing my love for you all. Or at least a strong like.
I just asked him, who are you referring to? He took too long to answer for me. So I FaceTimed him. And when I FaceTimed him, he said, if it was about you, and that's where it escalated for me. Because if I was wrong, and it wasn't about me, you could have said, hey, King, I don't like your tone, but I was not referring to you. And I would have apologized. And I'm going to keep saying this because I'm a real ass nigga. That's what I told him privately. And that's what I'm telling y'all. If I'm wrong, I can take accountability. Just like you wanted Royal to take accountability for the whole pulling your wig off thing. And Royal saying you wanted Royal to apologize while you had your hands around his neck. But now I'm applying pressure and you don't like the way I'm talking. You don't want to take accountability and say, hey, I don't like how you're talking and I wasn't talking about you. So who else could you be talking about?
Y'all saying that, oh, well, all this stuff that he could do for us and he could put us on and he could show us tricks, but you're nowhere charting. You're not on nobody's billboard. You're not on nobody's iTunes. You're not on nobody's major league podcast. For me, it was let this be the last
time. Let this be the last time. That at that point, it's like, all right, now I'm going to do it again next time I see you because now you're touching my game.
This is how I feel about it. They're very indirect and it's very annoying.
Like, you could just see the judgment on his face so fast. We are all on the same platform. Nobody is fabber than nobody.
And it's just, to me, kind of weird. So that's why I just sit in the back because this, I don't know. I feel like the way I handle it, everybody look like, oh my God, you're blowing shit out of proportion.
And then when shit really get real, people start talking about they brand and stuff. Bitch, please. Good night.
Right.
I just don't like the, I'ma do this when I see you. And then now everybody want to have conversations and be upset.
Yeah. You know, yeah. Like, do they not know the meaning of on site?
I'm excited. I'm happy. I'm stoked. I think it's gonna be a cute little time tonight.
So welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh, thank you.
Oh, they paying for bringing gifts, honey.
Expecting this event to be very grand. I mean, smells amazing.
You want that back? Or you want to put it in the cooler?
It's for them. It's not mine. I'm
right. You.
Oh, that's my.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. I know. He put it in the bag. Like, put it in the bag.
I hate to be the greedy bitch of the cast, but like, I like to come to events and I like to eat. Like, I like to eat. I like to have a good drink. If you're having an event, I expect there to be a nice little menu.
So the appetizers are already out. The side plates are right there. And then the main plates for the dinner. I just brought the dinner out and it's over there.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome, yeah. So knock yourself out and then come back. We'll have a conversation. I'll pull some chairs up for you.
That's mine.
It's good as
hell. We all enjoy that. Why you say so country?
Hey, you from North South?
The food is cute. Work Derek Doll.
If you're cold, feel free to get a blanket. Get comfortable. I have this game. I said earlier that tonight is gonna be where life imitates art with this group of people. You all are highly intelligent, creative, supportive, loving, busy-ass people. But I do want to know more about you.
It's a conversation game where you're prompted to talk about an experience, talk about your favorite things, anything that will make for a deep conversation to go below surface level.
And so is everybody down to play? Okay, if anyone doesn't want to play, you can totally let me know. This is a safe space. This is a no judgment zone. Positive vibes only. Okay, y'all ready to play?
Yes.
All right, so I'm gonna.
Right. Definitely looked around. I did not see Miss D, and she's well over 25.
When I met Miss D, she's a sweet person, but it just didn't seem like an event that she would be invited to. I was told to get dressed and look nice and be prepared to be at a classy event. And it's no shade to Miss D, but it's not giving classy event when she gets dressed from what I've seen. Like, it's giving me thrifty.
that is not a twerk.
It gives me Crocs. It gives me, you know, day at the playground. You know, it's not giving me day at a classy event.
Some of these children that have been hanging with us just don't even know how to have a conversation without yelling. Some of them are not even of drinking age. Some of them just don't have couth. So I'm not surprised at all that Derek does not want to bring the youngins to his home.
Would you rather go to jail for a murder you never committed or kill someone and never get caught? Now, if I did it, I will sit there in that jail and color on the walls. But it's given very much kill someone and never get caught.
It's okay. A great icebreaker.
You could give your parents advice on how to raise you. What would you tell them?
Ooh, yes.
The first thing I would tell my mother is to heal from whatever trauma. She was the hard one. My dad was the nurturer. And so, but she wanted me to be, you know, the good black boy. What is that? I don't know what that is. It's one of those situations where, like, you are not kind.
Yeah.
And I don't have to accept that.
It is great to see people being vulnerable, truly giving answers that reflect their mentality, their emotional state, their history and backgrounds.
It's your final 24 hours on Earth.
Oh my God.
You're in great shape and have limitless funds. What do you do? I would definitely have to take a couple hours out for like my family. Cause like, you know, okay.
Well,
mom, dad, love you, mean it, gotta go. But the rest of that shit? Oh, I'm catching a red eye with a good batch of girlfriends to like every country I could touch.
This shit, I feel like people, it takes time to get through to people.
This game is like, you know, I guess it opens our mind. It's cute, a little lengthy. But you know, it's different.
Read the question.
Given a chance, what would your worst enemy want to test you?
Your enemy would say that you're loyal to?
Your enemy, because listen, you know where I'm going with this.
Oh, I know who your enemy is. Oh yeah, you're right.
I'm hoping, you know, we could play a cute game of spades, you know, break up into two tables, child, put some money on the table, maybe some taboo or something.
This game is draining me. It's wearing me out. Like, the answers are too long. Everybody wanna give their whole motherfucking life story on where this came from and what this, like, it's just a snooze fest at this point.
If your life were a video game, which level would be the most difficult to get?
Let's move on. Let's get the drinks popping and let's have a good time.
Level 21. No, level 18.
Like, let's get on these couches and start twerking or something, child. Like, ugh.
It gives an older crowd game for sure.
If every human came with a warning label, what would yours say?
If every what?
If every human came with a warning label, what would yours say?
Okay.
It was cute, Derek Doll. Kudos to you. At least you had good food. And plenty of it.
Yes!
What a slight dribble.
I think that the event served its purpose. I'm very proud of the people that I invited. And we had a good time. Okay, I would like to raise a glass. You were drinking, you were. I'd like to raise a glass to all of you. Thank you so much for being here and for joining me tonight for our little cocktails and conversations. I hope that you all enjoyed the food. I hope you enjoyed the conversation. I appreciate you all so much for being here and for giving me an opportunity to get a chance to know some of you better. That's how community is built. Finding out how you relate to a person, despite whatever the differences are. How are we related and how do we continue to build on that part of our humanity? So, cheers to your successes. And cheers to future friendships.
And cheers to you.
Cheers.
You did that, doll.
Yes. I think the night went well. We got through it, no fight. The vibes were vibing. People made new friends.
Doll knows how to put it together.
It did get a little boring at times, but you know, those were the times that I walked to the balcony and had a smoke break.
Group day trip adventure number 2, very important.
It's another adventure day. Again, we don't know exactly what we're doing.
Surprise destination, surprise adventure number 2. You don't want to miss this event. This will be the best adventure of the season thus far. Be photo shoot ready. So that means I gotta contact my team and I gotta put
this. You borrow my stylist.
I don't need to borrow your stylist, sweetie. Mm-hmm. But thank you. I appreciate it. You can,
I don't know how we're going to act as a group together. Because it just seems like every time we get together as a group, it's so much drama.
We see each other. But,
see y'all at the event.
You're gonna
see you.
You finna go?
Oh, yeah.
Kenzie is my stylist. I'm wearing those. I'm wearing.
You told me you made the list, so you know.
I had made the list days ago. Yes, I did.
How was your meetup, the 25 and over?
It was cute. It was, the food was lovely. There was so much the charcuterie and the hors d'oeuvres and things like that, the wine.
Oh, I would have been pissed to go to Jersey for charcuterie, please.
No, there was dinner as well.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay.
It was real extra, and then we played a little game where we answered some meaningful questions. So Derek is sweet, and Derek is fake as hell. I found out she's not from New Jersey.
Who?
The doll.
Oh, Mirage. Mirage is not from Jersey?
How perfect.
Oh, they didn't invite my
brother. Who did you invite? And I was just like, you know, so he said something. I was like, so that's why you didn't invite Miss D? And then he like paused and was like, I think not expecting me to ask that question. He brought up the fact that you put the story in the group chat.
Okay.
Right, and that's when I was like, so that's why you didn't invite Miss D. And he was like, yeah, you know.
But you said it though. If you're not gonna take responsibility for what the fuck you said, bitch, don't post it. Yada, yada, yada.
No. It was yada, yada. It was like, bitch, you lying.
Bitch, you lying.
Got it.
You do the sub, mother court.
You know
the
what
sub.
The fuck you're doing.
You knew what the fuck you was doing, bitch. And I just let the kids know that you was doing that shit, bitch. And that's all. I'ma protect anybody in the group. The girl cannot play victim. She the way people are fucking with her is she fucking choked that fucking boy and everybody got their fucking guards up. Whatever anybody give you, bitch, on this motherfucking cast or show, it's because the fucking energy you put out there. But you know the crazy thing about it is I know that girl's husband. I know that girl's family. You know, in my web series and all my stuff, she knows how mother gives it up. So I don't even understand what she has a problem about it.
I think y'all should sit down and have a conversation.
It's fine. It's no love lost. I'm sorry. No. Bitches ain't gonna be like playing the victim and then they wanna be like, oh, I'm not inviting nobody here, nobody near.
Yeah, okay? No, of course. Yeah.
Right. And whatever energy anybody is giving you, whatever any energy anybody is giving you, they have the right to. Because we all witness an act of violence.
I was like, y'all two have made an alliance with each other.
You girls are from the past, and you want to play for the future. But yeah, it's no love lost. I don't want the girls to start thinking mother's playing villain. I don't want to be any Melly Bees.
Oh, well, so it's too late for that.
I mean, I don't care what they think, honestly. They brought all of that shit on themselves. I haven't done anything villainous. All I did was put something in the group to clarify.
Bitch is not telling the truth. Bitches don't like to live in the truth in this group. You know, you can't get mad because someone wants to clarify. Somebody wants to, like, get a greater understanding. What's wrong with that? Why are you mad at that?
I didn't call her. I didn't set that call up. I just put whatever in the group chat and left it aside.
No, but she was on the call.
Yeah, the girls included me in the call. And mother picked up. My children called.
My children called.
My children called.
Everybody got an alliance. Okay.
No, it's about an alliance. I fuck with everybody. Because at the end of the day, if they want to go toe-to-toe, blow for blow, you ain't choking me. Did you hear what the fuck I said?
toe to toe, blow for blow, bitch, you ain't choking me.
Toe to toe, blow for blow.
Then you want to talk shit and you ate my chicken, bitch. There's no alliance. I don't like one better than the other. To tell you the truth, I don't like none of you motherfuckers.
That's what I wanted to say.
Love you down. You could be the doll. You could be the mistress. You could be the head chief, the head bitch Charles. You could be all of that, honey. Right. But at the end of the day, I ain't losing no sleep the fuck over you. See you, speak to you, respect you. That's it, bitch. But if you putting something somewhere and throwing sub, I hate a subby bitch. I hate a subby bitch. You can't give it up that you're giving this ooh la la, this ta-ta. I'm right. The doll, I'm the primp, I'm the creme la creme, I'm charcuterie board, cheese, and dinner in a little studio apartment.
Yeah.
And then, you know, say that, this is why you didn't invite me. I'm fine with that, honey. I'm fine. Mother's fine with that. But don't make it like I'm the villain or you have an issue. Now that's wrong, sis. I've seen you twice, bitch, since we've been on the show. Okay?
How about that?
Twice. And that's why the fuck you didn't invite me to that party, because you know the next time I see you, I'm going to be like, Miley, what's good?
No, Josh, he in the cut, watching everything, not saying nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect, catching it all. I love him. Yeah. Because we had a couple, like, side-eyeing moments where we were like, what? Okay. Uh-huh.
There's a lot of lies. And a lot of lies.
Girl, I'm about to be frying chicken at Kris Jenner's house. I don't have that time to play with you girls.
Think that there's nothing wrong with y'all talk?
It's done. It's done. I'm done. You can have that. Build your alliance.
So I hear you're going to be here all day tomorrow?
I am going to be here all day tomorrow.
All day tomorrow, people!
Yeah. I'm here at Pride.
Everyone is a fucking twink today! You're a twink, and you're a twink, and you're a twink!
Yeah, that was good.
Hey, you people in the apartments, wake the hell up! So there's that.
It is Pride.
Please, drink up. Because the more you drink, the prettier I look.
Yes, and give it up for Brandon!
Today we are here celebrating Brooklyn Pride, and I am excited, yet another gig. I was asked to come and perform.
I just got booked by them to perform.
Ooh, come on, bitch.
That's not a
when?
Brooklyn Pride this Saturday. They say they cut off all five blocks.
Where is it?
Yeah. It's
going to
be on this block.
They was over there arguing, and I'm over here making connections. You see the difference?
This dog is bisexual. Like me. Buy me something and I'll be sexual with you. Just saying.
Today, I am performing at Brooklyn Pride by Brandon Saloon with wonderful Keke Couture. Basically, I'm excited to, you know, broadcast my talent. Why not? Because I'm talented, so I want to spread my music and love to people's ears.
So, like, what I want you to do is, I'm gonna be like, can I get a Hey Zulu?
Hey,
yeah.
Hey, Zuki butt.
Yeah, hold on. Let me give it them.
I wanted Zulu to hit the stage because I do believe in him. I think that he has a lot of growing to do, but he is so talented. And I think if he had someone to guide him, he could get far.
All right, wait, bitch. You got some cute-ass boys up in here.
Ah!
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm better than a hand job. Spread the word.
Girl, you better...
What? All right, I don't usually make men of color gag, but I just did this one anyway.
Girl!
I didn't mean to make this a part of a joke.
You did it.
Okay, good.
She
she was touching on me, and I'm like, girl, what is you doing?
I don't care if it's a bottom.
Girl, I'm like, we don't do drag queen. I can't do that.
Hey, I'm performing, and I'm like that, and this thing, don't play with it.
This thing, don't play with it. Don't play with it. This thing, don't play with it.
No, I did not know that once I took this booking that there was going to be kids here, okay?
She is so pretty. Look at her, Kiki. She's so pretty. Oh, look at her. She's so pretty. Oh, my God. Look at her.
A lot of the things I say in my music is not appropriate for children. I'm going to stick to these two songs, and I'm going to do a little something different.
I cannot wait to have a child. She's gorgeous.
We're being prideful. We have the rainbow. We got all kinds of people out here.
I think they over it. The group too.
Well, I hope they talk.
Look how you guys are getting along right now.
Well, having Royal here, I was happy to see him as well.
This drink is lit. I'm excited. I'm actually excited. I'm excited. I like what they've done with this for Pride. I think it's a beautiful thing.
Why do you think that she's fake or fake?
Well, KK can't talk about anybody being fake.
You think Royal fake?
He's fake for the when the camera comes on, he's a whole different person.
Whoa.
And that is?
That is the truth.
From the wigs that she be wearing, it's fake. She's a fake ass person. I don't really care why she thinks that I'm fake because Keke doesn't live the lifestyle of a gay man or anything that aligns close to it. She is a lesbian woman who gets to walk in and out of the spectrum whenever she feels comfortable and however it may benefit her. She's accepted by society.
Zulu and Royal's relationship, that is not a friendship. Okay, it's very one-sided. I put you on this show. These bitches ain't here for you. This. You always yelling at him like he your fucking child. Y'all both kids. Learn to communicate. Learn to talk.
Of course.
I'm Don't leave me.
Oh, no. Ooh, what happened? Ooh, bitch, what happened?
Bitch, now you gotta get on your knees.
It was giving the Gio moment.
I glue it back on.
Oh, no, my nail didn't fall off.
I pulled it off. How you support? Like, do you love it or do you think it's a good thing?
I like it and I don't like it at the same time because it's more of a like, oh, I supported you or, you know, you didn't give me anything. I always helped you. I always shared your music, you know. But then there's the, oh, I really genuinely support you. I want you to grow. I want your career to grow. I want you to grow. I want you to make this money. I want you to get what you want. I want you to follow your dreams. It could be a gift and a curse.
Are y'all ready for some entertainment? Oh, good Jesus. If I ever tell you anything, you have to be enthusiastic. Are y'all ready for some entertainment? That's better, bitches.
I really believe it's how you perform. You could have a hit single, but if you get on that stage and you're just not interacting with the crowd, they're not gonna like it.
I am really excited.
This next artist is and I don't say that about just anybody. She's got a lovely entourage, half of which I want to like inherit into my harem.
This thing.
But in the meantime,
y'all need to watch this.
Let's
y'all need to watch
this.
No, y'all need to watch this like right now. We need some black people.
Of Keke Couture.
I go alcohol.
Hi everyone. Oh my God, I'm so excited.
I'm singing. I'm not rapping.
Happy Pride. You guys look beautiful. My name is Keke Couture, and I'm going to perform two songs for y'all. Shout out to the children here. You're so beautiful. DJ, I'm like that. Thank you.
Yeah. She is talented. Keke is really talented. She's a beautiful person.
Turn it up. I like that. You like that? I like that. You like that? Yeah. DJ, give me some volume.
He said, I like the way
you throw that right back. Once he beat it, then he clean me like a cat. He said he need it cause all Egyptians is whack. He couldn't find another match to turn it up to the mat. I ain't talking too much, I let my actions do the talking. These bitches is stepping, it's a level that they can't walk in. I step in the lane, thicker than Bucky. The body that drove down in my ass. These bitches surgical cocky. Feeling myself, I'm feeling good, good. Trying to beat me, I wish you would. Yeah, you just can't, he treat me good, good. I keep him coming like he should, should. He give it up, yeah. I'm like that, huh? You like that, huh?
I like that. I like that. What happened here? Come on, Kiki.
I like that. You like that?
I do.
I like that.
Huh?
You like that? Yeah. Whoa.
They're definitely bopping their heads and they're, you know, they like it. They like it. It's always a beautiful moment for me.
You thought you was low. You funny bitch, you try to tiptoe. But a pussy bitch always pussy footing is a no-no. I hit a new level. You bitches still riding mine. I see you keeping it simple. Well, I'm choosing to keep the grind. So when down ain't the option, I'm not the one to pass the time. I already started a problem. Why you bitches standing in line? He like the way I do that right there. He see me stepping. I'm Gucci up with the fur. Like it when I drop it on his homie, sir.
Know, as an upcoming artist, it is very hard to perform for people that you don't even know. I really appreciate the love you guys are showing me right now. It's fucking Pride! So, I know we got some lesbians in the building. And some gays in the building. DJ, DJ, you could drop this ting. This ting.
Don't play with it.
This ting.
Don't play with it.
This ting. Don't play with it.
This ting.
Don't play with it.
That's not my song. This ting.
Don't play with it.
Come rub, come suck, come lay with it. This pucker is a greatest hit. It wet and set, good flavor shit. They wanna. Bounce, ha, ha. DJ, bounce, ha, ha. DJ, this ting.
Don't play with it.
This ting.
Let us song with it.
You know what?
Let that song go hard.
It's okay.
That's
it's okay when the DJ messes up. We all make mistakes, right? This ting.
Don't
come play with it. Come rub, come suck, come lay with it. This pucker is the greatest hit. It wet, it set, good flavor shit. They wanna bounce, ha, 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 hey, hey, bounce, ha, hey, hey, ha, hey, hey. I waited for this song, ha. I waited for this song, ha. I waited for this song, ha. I waited for this song. Y'all know I'm sweating up here.
You know, once I'm heated, there's no calming me down.
DJ, do you have it yet?
We're going to get to where you are, but we have to show where you came from. Because it's also Harlem Black Pride, too, going on. Like, Shreveport raised me, but...
Newark made me a man.
Newark, we'll do that.
I'm really a nice person, but I really have that side to me that I don't like to bring out. Once Keke come out, it's over. It's no telling me nothing. Because if I start the swinging, bitch, yeah, you're going to think you're in a boxing ring. Stop playing.
Each punch that I throw is releasing something and helping me to grow and take me to that next level.
that I'm single, so I don't have anybody.
I don't know the fucking direction I need to take. And then she's like, well, you need to find a way.
When you're ready for someone, what do? You go, God, I'm ready now. Send me a good man.
But I want you to be a grandma.
The plight of the Negro was met with adversity.
Very confident that I'm going to get through my monologue.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's
got it.
I was suffocating, taking short, shallow breaths. I couldn't make out the face. I struggled. And then I felt his prickly beard on my back.
If you scream, I kick.
Hi! How are you? Thank you, thank you.
Top 5 porn stars of all time.
What?
Lovers and friends.
I'm not supposed to be in all the rooms and all the spaces, and I get it. Your boo knows me and knows that that's not my thing. That's not my narrative.
That was the second time that you initiated something in the group chat causing a stir between people that I don't even know anything about.
It's Juneteenth and my ancestors would not like us to get on no fucking boat. So I'm not getting on a boat.
We got something big. Long and juicy waiting for you. Take the Staten Island Ferry over, enjoy the view, and let's get your roll on.
What the fuck is really gonna happen when we get over here? Because nobody has no fucking idea.
Why did you post that?
I didn't know who you were talking about. At the Brooklyn Pride.
It was not about me. Because they literally said it was about me.
I feel like it couldn't be about me because my video was paid for. Okay. I'm not a struggling.
Hey!
But that's not my problem. Right, your nature is my, I have my nature too.
Right, and you did what
you can't come at me like that.
However, I did.
So there's no issue.
I did.
You don't get it. So I'm gonna help you.
If it was about
I'm gonna start a whole I
will tag you. If you feel it's about you, you can.
I never thought it was about me. However, I didn't even know you had a video.
I don't think about y'all outside of this. Sorry.